Even with the rise of remote work, many Americans say that bullying remains a big problem at their jobs. So what do you do if you're a victim? Here to explain what to do is Dr. Gary Namie of the Workplace Bullying Institute. Doctor, good morning.
Good morning. Good morning, Raoul.
Okay, so let's get to this. Bullying at work doesn't just mean getting yelled at in front of others and that kind of thing, right? So what can it mean?
That's the caricature. It's mostly behind closed doors. And it's basically when someone mounts a systematic campaign of interpersonal destruction to either take you out, get you fired, set you up for failure, but also it causes extreme health harm. So that's the key. That's really, really, really the key.
Let's talk about how do you know, because a lot of people, strangely enough, don't even realize that they're being bullied, right? So how can you identify that?
That's right. Again, it's health. You have to look for changes in your own health. And you know who's more likely to catch that? Your doctor or your family. The targets, we don't call them victims. The targets are often the last to know. And so, yeah, it takes a long, long time. The quicker the recognition, the less the harm. But the problem is we consider it basically an occupational hazard in America, where we think this is routine work and this is why they call it work and all the rest of that. But I think that with the great reckoning and people having all the time off and with COVID, I think they're starting to search for greater meaning, and they're looking back and saying, I don't need to take that crap anymore.
That's a very good point. In terms of identifying, let's go back to that, because we do have some bullet points for people, right? Like humiliation and blocking promotions and that. Can you kind of go through that list for us and explain a little bit of each?
Verbal abuse.
Yep.
If you perceive there's verbal abuse, and it's your perception that counts, not the bully's, because the bully will say you're misinterpreting. Threats, humiliation, intimidation, all of those tactics, usually through a lot of nonverbal behavior, but also there's tactical sabotage. Somebody's trying to prevent you from getting your work done, completely interfering and setting you up for failure. Yes.
Let's talk about the employers, what they're doing wrong when it comes to workplace bullying, because when you mentioned setting unrealistic, impossible expectations, that kind of reeks of the bosses doing most of the bullying here.
Yeah, we do national surveys, and in the last one, it's still 65% top down.
Wow.
And bully boss is acute alliteration, but it's also from coworkers. Almost a quarter of the bullying is from coworkers too. Wow. But it is primarily top down. Hey, it's good to have the power to be able to inflict harm on somebody else. Mm. And bosses are given that power, unfortunately. What are employers doing? Oh, that's the question. Not enough. Not enough. And you know why? Because in the United States, we're the last of the Western countries, the industrialized nations, to actually address workplace bullying. We don't have our laws passed yet.
So you mentioned the climate in the workplace. If you're a victim, what can you do?
You can't fight back alone. That's the first thing to understand. Do not blame yourself for your fate. Know that you're not alone. That's incredibly important. And second, know that you did not cause it. However, you need to find a way to rally your coworkers to find common experiences, because you're not the only one. You're not the first. You won't be the last, as long as that particular bully is still on the payroll. So find a way to compare notes and then find collective action and go tell the employer you want safety. Not that you want the bully fired, that scares them. They're not gonna do that. Management is supporting the bully most of the time, but that what you need is safety. And push this term psychological safety, because it's all over the world except in the US. We think about falling off of ladders and OSHA type injuries. Psychological safety is much more damaging when it is violated. And that's what you want. Now, if your employer doesn't give that to you, you're really going to seriously have to consider, if they will not make you safe, how much longer can you tolerate being in a place that's making you ill?
That is a very good point. Great advice. Dr. Gary Namie, we thank you for the time this morning.
Thank you.